Hey everyone, this is Kirk here again at OptionAlpha.com, and in this video I want to answer a question that we get often on the membership side of our website and on the blog. And people always ask and they want to know what the optimal probability of being in the money is, or probability of being out of the money. So what's the level at which we sell options at whatever probability level we want, whether it's 60% or 80%. But is there an optimal level for return and risk or margin usage? So what's the point at which we're, you know, using our capital best for the best possible return that we can? And so one of the ways that we're going to look at it is just through a quick little study we did with IWM naked puts. And the reason we chose naked puts is because they're very easy to quantify as far as risk and return with the margin requirements that are in there. So credit spreads are going to be a little bit different, same with iron condors. But with naked puts, it's very easy, kind of black and white to see. So on the chart here, you see we have the probability of being in the money running across the top. So we made some sample trades with IWM at a 60% probability of making money or being out of the money, and at a 70% probability of being out of the money, an 80% and a 90%, just kind of blocking these four out. Now you can see the credit that we receive for selling just one of these IWM naked puts is here. So for the 60% level, you obviously got compensated a lot more because you took in more in credit. At the 70% level, you got less, but you still took in 166. 80% you took in 112. 90% you took in $47 of credit. And then again, down here below, just kind of skip down with me, the margin requirement to hold just one of these for the 60% level, because you're trading closer to where the market's trading, you're having to put up a little bit more money in margin. So you put up $2,010, and then you can see it slowly starts to decrease after that because you're going further out of the money, so brokers will adjust the risk. Now, the return on capital, or ROC down here, is just simply the credit that you receive divided by your initial margin requirement. So you can see you get compensated, obviously, as you should in an efficient market, for coming closer to the market's current price. So if you reduce your probability of success, you will increase the potential return on capital that you have if you're right. Not to say that you will be right, but if you are right. So it'll go down, or it'll, with the 60% level, you're at about a 12% return. At the 70% level, about 9.68. At the 80% level, just under 8. And at the 90% level, about 5% return on capital. Now, where it starts to get really interesting with this study is the differential. So what we just put in here as difference. The reduction in the credit that you received going from the 60% probability level to the 70% level was a 29.66% reduction in your credit. So about a 30% reduction. Going from the 70% level to the 80% level, you had an even bigger reduction percentage-wise of about 32%. And then going from the 80% level to the 90% level, it almost doubled as far as you were getting almost, your reduction in credit was increasing exponentially almost as you went further and further out of the money. So you can see that as you go further and further out in selling premium, it's not this one lockstep that everything has. So as you go 10% out, you get a 10% reduction. It just doesn't work that way. So you can see here with evidence that we've shown with IWM that you actually have an increasing differential. And as you get out from 80 and 90, it starts to really accelerate. The same thing happened with your return on capital. So the reduction as a percentage of return on capital got reduced going from 60% probability level to 70% probability level. There was a reduction in your return by 17%. So again, that's the differential percentage-wise between 11.71 and 9.68. And again, you can see it starts to really accelerate. As you go from the 70% level to the 80% level, it increased to a 19% reduction in return. And then again, you can see it almost doubled as we went out to the 90% probability level, with a 41% reduction in your return based on the return on capital between 80 and 90% probability. So you can see there's definitely some sort of clear line that's in between about 80 and 90% that really kind of encompasses the best use of capital, the slowest or the best use of return on capital for the least reduction in credit. And that's what we're kind of looking for here. We know that as you go further and further out, you get much less credit and much less return than coming back closer. So it's not worth going really, really far out of the money, say the 90% or 95% probability of success level. And although that has really great returns, it may not be the best use of your capital. So based on most of the pricing that we've seen, and we have found that somewhere around the one standard deviation probability level, as would probably come as no surprise because that's based on everything that we have around option pricing and statistics, gives us probably the most optimal use of funds or the biggest for the biggest credit received. So the point at which our credit received is probably the most optimal for the money that we're putting up in capital. So this would be the 85% probability of being out of the money. And again, it's probably somewhere between here where that kind of yield curve starts to really accelerate and kind of have some sort of optimal area, somewhere between 80 and 90. But we know that we can come in closer and take in more credit. We just have to realize that we're not gonna be as successful trading. So we're not gonna have the high number of wins that we would like to have. So if you wanna have really high number of wins, you should probably be somewhere around the one standard deviation level, which again, is about the 85% probability of success area. So hopefully this has been really helpful. I know it was only a couple slides, but it's got a lot of information in here and really helps kind of quantify why we do what we do as far as return and capital usage. And again, if you have any comments or questions, please add them right below this video on the lesson page. I'll make sure I get back to all of those questions and get you guys answers if you have them. Until next time, happy trading.